I grew up living in Sonoma Creek. I was lucky enough to grow up in this lovely valley, and Sonoma Creek was one of my homes. And watching it deteriorate to the point of where there's little or no water in it, there's no wildlife in it. There are some herons, and there's a few, frogs, but there's no fish. When I lived at Oak Hill Farm, and there was this dirt road that went next to one of the flower fields, and I would walk that road a lot, and so I decided that, well, I might as well try to paint a picture of it. And it's unfortunately, well, fortunately, I don't live on Oak Hill Farm anymore. There was a lot of problems living on a farm. And I like living in sort of the residential Boyce Springs area. Makes me feel like one of the people. I was doing this painting, I kept thinking of Sylvia Crawford. Now, I'm mentioning Sylvia because I really like Sylvia. She does the Glen Ellen column in the Index Tribune. She's done it for years. And I would meet her and we would talk about, she just would have seen my work and just raved about it all the time because I could paint this valley and paint Glen Ellen so well. So I said, well, I'm gonna paint Glen Ellen. And so this is my impression of Glen Ellen. Now this is a painting I did of an impression of a walk I went on to Wingo. And Wingo is south of Sonoma. It's along Sonoma Creek. And we walked along Sonoma Creek and I took some mental sketches and came home. And it was a day somewhat like today. It was kind of like, you know, a lot of smoke in the air and it was probably midsummer. Because I remember we were severely sunburned. Then I've decided to do a historical painting. Very rare do I ever do anything historical or whatever, but I decided that it was time for someone to do the burning of the Wolf House. A friend of mine was writing an article, Jonah Raskin, and he was doing this whole thing on Jack London and the burning of the Wolf House. So I said, well, I'm going to do a burning of the Wolf House painting. And so I got pictures of the Wolf House, and it was really kind of an amazing thing that he was going to build there. I mean, it was really kind of, you know, a spectacular castle, really, for a socialist.
I've been there, of course.
Yeah. And so I decided it's been pretty glorious burning up. My post-suburban landscapes done as a response to being at Temelec and at a friend's house and looking at the landscapes, that landscape job that everybody did with their house and thinking, well, gee whiz, you know, if there's some plague that takes us all out, these houses will turn into compost. But their landscapes will just take over, and they will just be these amazing jungles.
Okay, how about this painting?
I did this painting many years ago as a response to reading about the way Max Ernst approached his work. And he had a specific symbol in his work, which was a bird. And he also, when he started his paintings, he started them quite abstractly, and then sort of reduced them and did sort of a reduction. And so when I was doing this painting, I reduced it down to this sort of almost reptilian little elemental creature that I think represents the deep forces of the earth, sort of like the reptilian brain of the earth. And I just really liked this painting, and that's why I presented it to the producer of this video as in great appreciation of his work. I transcribe music that I listen to. And I listen to tons of music, and I sit here at night and I'm listening to a variety of different kinds of music, from classical to jazz to, I mean, I listen to everything. So it's really hard to say, but one of my favorite composers is Sergei Prokofiev. And that may be inspired by something he did. And then here's one that I did. This was the first one that I did, was based on the guitar solos of Frank Zappa. And I had bought this album called Shut Up and Play Your Guitar by Frank Zappa, and I would just listen to these over and over again and paint. And this was sort of what came out listening to Shut Up and Play Your Guitar. Days when you turn on the radio and you hear that they've had an oil blowout in the Gulf of Mexico, oh boy. And you sort of go, well, what do you do about that? And I had come across many years ago in the Book of Revelations, there is the angel of the bottomless pit is called Abandon. And I went, this is kind of like they've opened up the bottomless pit, you know, because they just kept pouring oil out of there. And I just kept thinking, you know, they're never going to get this thing closed. I can't imagine how they're going to do this. And they did it. They finally got it closed. And then I've got a whole series, and this will end it up here. These are nocturnes. I've got a whole series of these dark family of monster type paintings. I sort of like Goya. I like Goya's dark work, and I like, there's another artist I've discovered, an Italian guy named Salvador Rosa. And he painted very dark, I mean, he's painted witches hanging people. You know, just, and it was like 1450. He painted these paintings, and so when you look at his work now, you just go, this guy's a modern artist. This guy is a modern expressionist artist. And he was another one of those sort of had a warrant out for him, and hung out with a lot of questionable characters, a lot of outlaws and stuff. Yeah, as a friend of mine said about a lot of these kind of paintings that I paint, was I could never own one of these because I'm having enough trouble with my own unconscious. So there we go. Is that a wrap?